Hello friends, now I am talking about PSM. Okay, I am reading PSM one liners. This is again given by Dr. Bhatia Coaching Institute, so the credit goes to them. Okay, I just got this from a common group where there are around 300 to 500 people and they share the documents. Now let me read the very important points in PSM. Okay, there are around 60. Okay, we'll just read in 10 minutes. So McNaughton rule is concerned with criminal responsibility. Okay, so McNaughton rule is concerned with criminal responsibility and delusion is a disorder of thought. Okay, delusion is a disorder of thought. Hallucination is false sense of perception without any external stimulus. Without any external stimulus, if you feel some false perception, it's called hallucination. Kleptomania is a type of impulse. Kleptomania is theft, like you just take away things without anyone's knowledge and feel happiness in that, and that is an impulse disorder. The law of criminal responsibility of an insane person in India is based upon McNaughton's rule. Just remember, the law of criminal responsibility of an insane person in India is based on McNaughton's rule. Okay, so the same thing, same point, first point, they repeated again. The most common form of hallucination in schizophrenia is auditory. So auditory hallucinations are most common in schizophrenia. Maximum number of days during which a patient can be kept for observation for diagnosis of mental illness is 30. Okay, beyond 30 you should not keep them to diagnose mental illness. Recommended number of examinations before certification of mentally ill person is 3. There should be at least 3 certifications. The Indian Lunacy Act was replaced by Mental Health Act in 1987. So 1987 Mental Health Act came into existence, and before it was Indian Lunacy Act. In delirium tremens, the person is not criminally responsible for his acts. See, delirium tremens is nothing but confusion. So if he does any crime, he is not responsible for it. Testamentary capacity means mental ability to make a valid will. Lucid interval is seen in insanity. So just remember, lucid interval is seen in insanity. Sections for criminal responsibility are IPC, criminal responsibility of mentally ill, not liable. IPC, intoxicated against his will, not liable. IPC, intoxicated voluntarily liable. So this they did not give properly. We'll go with IPC sections in other video. Okay. Now anterior horn cells of spinal cord are affected in strychnine poisoning. So anterior horn cells of spinal cord are affected in strychnine poisoning. Most common posture during a strychnine poison is opisthotonus. So opisthotonus is the most common posture. Okay, so opisthotonus is the most common posture in strychnine poisoning. Anterior horn cells are affected in strychnine poisoning. Strychnine poison mimics tetanus. Okay, so there are 3 bits in strychnine poisoning. Anterior horn cells are affected. The most common posture is opisthotonus. Strychnine poison mimics tetanus. Fatal dose of Nux vomica is 1 crushed seed. So Nux vomica, if you eat 1 crushed seed, the person dies. The antidote for the Datura poisoning is physostigmine. Okay, Datura, physostigmine. Dryness of mouth, dilated pupil and delirium are seen in poisoning by Datura. So what are the symptoms seen by poisoning by Datura? The dryness of mouth, dilated pupil and delirium. The highest concentration of cannabinol is found in carrots. Okay. The highest concentration of cannabinol is found in carrots. Just remember, carrots, highest concentration of cannabinol. Okay, reefer or pot is related to marijuana. So reefer or pot is related to marijuana. Tetrahydrocannabinol is the active principle of marijuana. Okay, run amok is seen in cases of chronic addiction to cannabis. So run amok is seen with cannabis, chronic addiction to cannabis. An addict develops delusions, misleading hallucinations of sight and hearing, and feeling of creeping things, of grains of sand in the skin. Then he is addicted to cocaine. So we call them as cocaine bugs. Like he feels like ants are crawling on the body. So an addict develops delusions, misleading hallucinations of sight and hearing and feeling of creeping things, of grains of sand in the skin. He is addicted to cocaine. Formication is a type of tactile hallucination. Formication is what I said before, like it crawling of ants. Okay. Glue sniffing is inhalation of petroleum distillate. What is glue sniffing? It's the inhalation of petroleum distillate. Glue sniffing is inhalation of petroleum distillate. Okay. Okay. Flashback phenomenon is associated with LSD. So flashback phenomenon is associated with LSD. These are very important bits and confusing. So I'm going to repeat it again. So just be with me. Flashback phenomenon is associated with LSD. Liquid girl in the urine of addicts of amphetamine. Liquid girl is the urine of addicts of amphetamine. Okay. So just remember, RL means gold. RN is gold, I think. Aurium is gold. Okay. So aurium and amphetamine, AA. So liquid gold is urine of amphetamine. Ecstasy, a ray of party drug, is related to amphetamine. Ecstasy is related to amphetamine. Meow is a designer drug made from mephedrone. So meow, it is made from mephedrone. The sensation of synesthesia, seeing, smells, and hearing colors, occurs in LSD. So sensation of synesthesia, seeing, smells, and hearing colors. Okay, so there is a mix of senses, like seeing, smells, and hearing colors. I don't know how this can happen. Only if you experience it, you can know. So it happens in LSD, hearing of colors and seeing of smells. So is used for cattle killing, is prepared from Arbus precatorius. Toxalbumin, ricin, is obtained from castor seed. So ricin is obtained from castor seed. Ophitoxemia refers to poisoning due to snake venom. So this is ophitoxemia. Polyvalent anti-snake venom is prepared by hyper-immunizing horses against venoms of cobra, Russell's viper, common crate, and sarscale viper. That is polyvalent. So how is it prepared? Polyvalent anti-snake venom. It is prepared by hyper-immunizing horses against venoms of cobra, Russell's viper, common crate, and sarscale viper. The most common type of poisonous snake in India is common crate. Just remember, it's not cobra, it's common crate. Common crate is the most common poisonous. Okay. Priapism may be a presenting feature in case of Spanish flybite. Okay, priapism can be a presenting feature in Spanish flybite. Hematuria occurs in bites by viper. That is why it is hemotoxic, and cobras are neurotoxic. Spectacle mark on the dorsum of the head is an identification feature of common cobra. That is why in the hood it will be like a spectacle mark, like this it will be there. So it's a identification mark of common cobra. Venom of crate is neurotoxic. Okay, the viper is hemotoxic, crate is neurotoxic. Okay, luminescent vomit and fecus are diagnostic of poisoning by phosphorus. Okay, so if vomit and fecus are luminescent, then it is phosphorus poisoning. Fossy jaw is seen in case of chronic poisoning by phosphorus. So fossy jaw is seen in chronic poisoning by phosphorus. Okay, parotid gland swelling occurs in chronic poisoning with iodine. So parotid gland swelling occurs in chronic poisoning with iodine. Okay, chelating agent of choice in arsenic poison is dimercaprol or bal. So this is very important bit. For arsenic poison, use dimercaprol or BAL. Okay. Yeah. Desferoxamine is a specific antidote for poisoning of iron. Antidote used in case of acute arsenic poisoning is freshly precipitated hydrated ferric oxide. Okay. So for arsenic, generally is dimer, copper and ball. Okay, desferoxamine is antidote for iron poisoning. Antidote used in case of acute arsenic poisoning is freshly prepared hydrated ferric oxide. So for acute arsenic poisoning, use freshly prepared hydrated ferric oxide. Test used for detection of arsenic is Marsh test. Okay. So test used for detection of arsenic is Marsh test. And arsenic poison mimics cholera. So there are many questions in arsenic. We just read like arsenic poisoning, there are drug of choice or chelating agents is dimercaprol. But in acute arsenic poisoning, we give precipitated hydrated ferric oxide. Okay. And antidote for desferoxamine is iron. Okay. And for arsenic, we do Marsh test. So Marsh test is for arsenic. Okay. Yes. Marsh test is for arsenic. Arsenic poisoning mimics cholera. Okay. Arsenic poisoning mimics cholera. Velvety appearance of stomach is seen in acute poisoning with arsenic. Again, arsenic. Velvety appearance of stomach is seen with arsenic. Raindrop type of pigmentation is seen in chronic poisoning with arsenic. So again, raindrop pigmentation is seen with arsenic. Aldrich maze lines is associated with chronic arsenic poisoning. Mixoviruses like influenza virus are cultured on amniotic cavity and allantoic cavity of chick embryo. So mixovirus like influenza can be cultured on amniotic cavity of chick embryo, amniotic and allantoic cavity of chick embryo. Hemagglutinin and neuraminidase antigens are strain specific in influenza virus. Hemagglutinin and neuraminidase are specific in influenza. Okay, hemagglutinin and neuraminidase antigens are strain specific in influenza viruses. The type specific antigen A, B or C of influenza viruses is found on nucleocapsid protein. Okay, so the type specific antigen of influenza viruses is found on nucleocapsid protein. The principal reservoir for the generation of variants of influenza virus A due to antigen exchanges are pigs, horses and fowl. So the principal reservoir for the generation of variants of influenza viruses, that is due to antigenic shift, or pigs, horses and fowl. Best specimen for the laboratory diagnosis of influenza is nasopharyngeal washings. Okay, best specimen for laboratory diagnosis of influenza is nasopharyngeal washings. Ray syndrome is most often seen with influenza B. Just remember, Ray syndrome is with influenza B. Okay, avian influenza is due to H5N1. Okay, para influenza virus is leading cause of croup syndrome. So croup syndrome is caused by para influenza virus. So para influenza virus. Orchid is usually unilateral, is most common complication in post pubertal males. So orchitis is the most common complication in post pubertal males, that too unilateral. Mumps infection is preventable by immunization LAV using Gerolstein. So Gerolstein is for mumps. Danish 1331 is for BCG. It's a BCG stain. Okay. Warthin fenicalidae cells are present in infection with measles. Okay. And Edmonstone Jagrep test is also for measles. Most common cause of death in measles is pneumonia. So I'll wind up with this. Okay, I'm not repeating again. You just play the video once more, because the time is very short. I'll come with the next video very soon. Thank you. Good luck.